So how is insomnia treated? Well, there's a number of treatments for insomnia, but to understand the treatments, it's important to understand how we conceptualise insomnia and how insomnia actually develops. So most of the time, by the time people are seeking help from a health professional about insomnia, it's not something that's been going on for a few days, it's something that's been going on for weeks to months. And once insomnia has been going for weeks to months, some of the characteristics are that there's a changed thinking about sleep and a changed behaviour about sleep. So particularly by the time someone's coming to see someone like myself, a specialist who works in this area, they've had insomnia symptoms for a while. So they've not only had that acute episode that's triggered insomnia, say acute stress or a change in circumstances, and in fact that's often passed into the distance, they're now behaving differently about sleep. Things like going to bed earlier, staying in bed later, missing out on activities in the morning because they feel more tired, thinking about sleep differently, feeling they're getting a bit anxious on sort of getting ready for bed, that fear of what's sleep going to be like tonight, and also a bit fearful of the next time there might be a threat to sleep in the future. So looking down the track and saying, oh, I've got that thing in a couple of weeks, and how am I going to manage my sleep around that? So that's why the treatment has to address each of those components. So one of the treatments used for insomnia is the use of sleeping pills. But sleeping pills arguably are best for that short-term acute insomnia where we just need a couple of days to get past that stressful circumstances, you know, sudden loss of a loved one, for example. They don't really have a great role for longer-term insomnia unless there's a medical reason why we've got insomnia. The mainstay of longer-term insomnia treatment is a psychology-based approach, so working on changing some of those behaviours around sleep and changing the way we think about sleep. That's called cognitive behavioural therapy. Now, the good news is that's a really effective treatment for insomnia, with 4 out of 5 people who go through that sort of treatment over, on average, 4 to 6 sessions with a psychologist over a 3-month period, 4 out of 5 people at 12 months saying their insomnia symptoms are much better. So it's a nice, really effective treatment that doesn't require long-term use of medications, but does take a bit of work, so it's not a quick fix. So in managing insomnia, it is important that we address each of these components, because if we rely just on one treatment, say sleeping pills, but still behaving differently around sleep, we're just not going to get the results that we're after.
For the A to Z of sleeping well, head to the hub, sleephub.com.au.